Hey guys, for this video, I'm going to walk you through how I took this printed flyer created for the Scars Foundation and turned it into an AR experience using Adobe Aero. So, I started it by selecting the anchor image, which is an image you use to, as you guessed it, to anchor the complete AR experience and animations rather than using any surface in your environment. The anchor image is the visual that the Adobe Aero app will look for in your real-time environment to trigger and launch the AR. This can be on a screen, business card, flyer, or even a painting. I find using an anchor image compared to using, say, a random surface in your environment, it gives you more control of the augmented reality from size, positioning, and honestly, sometimes I find the elements are a little bit unpredictable and gets a little bit wonky without the anchor image. So once the anchor is placed, you start by importing all your layers one at a time and arranging in attendant order, adjust your positions and your size to decide how close you want the elements to be from each other along with the anchor. Also, I would like to note that these elements are created in Adobe Illustrator and separated out in layers and exported as PNGs based on how I wanted them to animate together once I imported in Adobe Aero. For example, I wanted all the clouds to be animated together, so I kept them on the same layer in Adobe Illustrator before exporting. However, if you do not intend to animate the AR experience and want it simple, quick, and static, then you can easily just arrange layers in, let's say, Photoshop, import that Photoshop file into Adobe Aero, and adjust the space between the layers to create your diff. After you're done and satisfied with your layers, select a layer, then open a behavior panel on the bottom left and use the drop-down menu to choose an action. In this case, I wanted the bubbles to float up and down while the clouds move left and right. Therefore, I chose the move action followed by adjusting the X and Y axis for each layer, setting a duration for the animation and an animation trigger that starts the animation, whether it's from being in proximity, from the beginning, or tap, and so on. Once you're done setting up behaviors, you're ready to go by using Adobe Aero mobile app. Select your project and find an anchor image to start the experience. I just want to say thanks for viewing, everyone. Feel free to like, comment to let me know what else I can touch on in the future, share and subscribe as I plan to have more Adobe Aero tutorials in the future, eventually using 3D elements and also more Photoshop illustration lifesavers.